Good Lord, didn't anybody here subscribe? Thank you.
Experience has shown me the too high a ratio diminishes efficiency. I worked with the mixture until I found the right balance.
The magnetic plasma transfer to the warp field generators doesn't correspond to the recommended specs.
Right. Again, I adjusted the flow. Sometimes things happen a little differently in space than they do on the drawing board.
Is that a criticism, Commander?
No, of course not. It's just a well-known fact. There's theory and there's application. They don't always jive.
You've charted a completely new swap-out schedule for main components replacement.
You bet. I found Starfleet estimates for the MTBF units to be unrealistic. I simply determined my own schedule based on observation and experience.
Is that going to be your only defense, Commander? That same tired rhetoric? Out here in the field, we learn things you designers couldn't possibly understand.
In the first place, Doctor, I'm not aware of needing any defense. And in the second place, if you're determined to be...
Dr. Brahms, you have an incoming message on subspace.
I'd like to hear this message privately.
In my office, be my guest.
Thank you.
Commander, I am picking up some unusual readings in the Alpha Omicron system. At this range, all I am able to discern is that it is an asymmetrical field of intense energy.
What type of radiation signature?
Unknown, sir. The Alpha Omicron system is yet to be charted. I recommend we take this opportunity for further research.
Well, we're way ahead of schedule. Alter course for Alpha Omicron.
Dr. Brahms, there's no reason for us to argue. We're on the same side here.
I'm aware of that.
So why don't I take you on a little tour, show you the adjustments I've made, why I think they work, and we can begin pulling together on this? Okay. And why not start with the dilithium chamber? Okay?
Okay.
The anomaly is orbiting the seventh planet, sir. It is a mass of plasma energy contained within discrete boundaries by an outer covering of silicates, actinides, and carbonaceous chondrites.
On screen. Magnify. Is it a ship?
It does not conform to any known design.
Any records of similar phenomena in Starfleet listings?
No, sir. This has never been seen before.
Ensign Rega, ahead one quarter impulse.
Aye, sir.
Put us in orbit of the seventh planet. Keep us a relative distance of 10 kilometers from the object.
Alert science stations to stand by. Tell them to coordinate all efforts with Commander Data.
Aye, sir.
What happened here? Who did this?
You remember the crystal's been reoriented to adjust the direction of the lattice structure.
Remember? Why would I remember?
Right. Why would you? Well, the ship was experiencing some difficulty and we made this adjustment hoping that it would work, and it did.
So it was your idea?
Not exclusively, no.
It's curious. This modification was due to be introduced in
the next class starship.
Yes. How did you know that?
I didn't. I mean, well, it's the next logical step, right? Listen, Doctor, sometimes we have to fly by the seat of our pants out here, so it stands to reason that once in a while we're gonna come up with the same solutions you do. Listen, I've got a personnel review scheduled to start in about 5 minutes, and I know it's been a long day for you. So why don't we get together later? Sort of plan out our agenda for the next day or two?
Agenda?
What it is we want to accomplish here, how we might best go about that, maybe even get to know each other a little bit. It might make this easier.
Maybe you're right.
Okay, great. How about my quarters? 1900 hours? Maybe even have a bite to eat? I make a great funjili.
I love funjili.
Is that right? Huh.
beans, oh beans, lots of beans, lots of beans, lots of beans, yeah.
I love beans, diggity doo.